What other occupations were there in the village?
There was only two things really. You'd either got to go into a chair factory as a chair maker, or you'd got to go farm as a farmer. So you see, there was only the two choices.
What about the potters?
Oh, well, the potters' arms, yes. Of course, then you see, they didn't employ a lot of people, not the potters' arms. You see, although they turned out a terrific lot of stuff, there was only two pot makers, two making the pots, one man a labouring, and another one to do look after the horse and carts and carry the clay in and so on.
Yeah, what were their names?
Ellen, Albert Ellen, Stan Francis, Tom Sears, and Arthur X. That was the four main people working there.
Who run the business? Who's the
Hobbs,
boss?
Jim Hobbs.
He was the landlord?
He was the landlord at the Potter's Arms.
You were telling me about the big kiln that they had.
Oh yes, that's right, yes. Of course they got 12 fires around that. I used to burn that for 14 days, straight off the rail, day and night.
Was that fired by wood?
Oh, no, all coal.
What's...
Oh, you fancy 12 fires, all open fires round the kiln. And of course there was one big chimney, of course.
What sort of pots did they produce?
Flower pots and pans.
What sort of pans?
Oh, these bread... You don't remember the old bread pan, do you? The old earthenware bread pan.
Oh, I think I know what you
and
mean.
And the lids. We used to put the lids on as well.
Pots?
There used to be... There was one, two... Three clay pits on Winchmore Hill Common. You know the area in front of Nelson Close? That was one great big pit, clay pit. Oh, they took the clay from everywhere.
So it must have made an awful lot of pots.
Oh, yes. Well, the last clay pit that they dug was up in Westers. You know the Cosel Lane from here at Cosel, don't you?
Yes.
You know that wood that lays on the left-hand side? That's where you'll find the heap, but there's a heap of clay there now.
Is there?
Yeah. Hundreds of tons of it.
Because they had to get the right type of clay, didn't they?
Oh, yes. Oh, yes.
Because somebody told me that they actually run out of the right type of clay. I don't know whether that's true or not.
No, not for making pots, but they tried an experiment to make bricks, and that wouldn't work.
No.
No, well, of course, the reason they finished was, you see, the old Jim Hobbsy died.
Yeah.
And there was nobody to leave the business to. And that a cousin of theirs, he took it, the place over, and he thought he was going to make a fortune of making tiles and bricks.
Oh, yes.
And the clay wasn't suitable. Of course, that finished the whole thing.
Yeah. You've got a visitor.
Gladys?
No, when we had the pond out here...
I know the old big pond, yeah.
My father said when you stood in the bottom of it, you could only see the top of the chimneys because they took the clay from there for the brick pan.
A clay pit.
Well, it filled up with water and someone had put an old bath on it, you see. And I got in it and Ruby pushed me and I sailed out to the middle and Sid came along with his stick and put it over the side and pulled me to the side and just saved my life. If I'd have stood up, I should have tipped in right in the deepest part.
That's when you were a girl?
Yes.
Was it very deep?
Oh yes, very deep, wasn't it?
Oh yes, that was a real deep one.
I think I can remember it when it was like a big dell, empty.
That's right, yes that's right.
We had some fun on it in the winter though, skating, didn't we? You'd go skating on it.
Oh yes. And fishing.
Yes. Yeah.
What sort of fish?
Oh, we stocked them in... Well, what do you call these little pond fish? Well, about 2 or 3 inches long.
To go wooding and leaf moulding.
Oh.
Stacks of leaf mould I've brought home for our chickens in our garden.
Yeah.
Drop of good stuff, was it?
Your dad never went in for pigs, though, did he?
No.
No.
Rabbits.
Rabbits, yes, that's right.
Yeah. When my eldest daughter was little... we had a lovely white coat made for, you know. He saved all the skins and sent them away and had them dressed.
Oh, did he?
Yeah, and I think Trevor's children had pram covers and things. He saved every skin.
Yeah.
Can you remember the potters over?
Yes.
You can?
Yes.
Oh, yes. Well, ain't that old Charlie Francis from Coozle? Used to work at Dancer and Earn.
Well, he looks like a Francis. He looks like Lloyd.
Yes, that's
like
right.
Lloyd.
Yeah, well, it was his. It
and
would
Lloyd
be,
would be
it
his
would
grandson,
be Lloyd.
Yeah,
okay, yeah.
Yes, he does.
I'm sure.
You'd think that was Lloyd if you look at it again.
It might be.
No, he's only my age.
Oh, if that ain't a Francis, I never seen
no.
one.
Oh, what is it? That's an interesting story. Now, old George Sawyer, he built that factory, as I've told you. Well, he also had this farm up here. See? Winchmore Farm. Well, he farmed that. Tom Woodbridge, he owns about 12 acres the other side. Well, he built his house on that piece of ground. And of course, Sawyer and Woodbridge never agreed very well together. So Sawyer locked the gate and closed his right away. See?
Yeah.
Tommy didn't know what to do. So I said to him, well, I said, why don't you lock him in? See? I said, that's a good idea, said. So he done them on, he goes off and he buys a lock and a chain, and he puts a lock and chain on it. When Sawyer wanted to get through his fields the other side of the road, he couldn't get through. So, of course, they had to come to an agreement between the two of them, and they both agreed to take their locks off.
That sounds the most sensible decision.
Yes.
He says he can remember putting a tin of water on top of the pole of your father's lathe first thing in the morning, so when your father treadled it, the tin
that's
of
right,
water
would tip over.
That was one of the tricks he played.
Yes. Yeah, another favourite trick that we used to have. Yeah, you know the ledge on top of a door, the frame, door frame?
Yes.
You get a nice little tin of water and put a little piece of string, a little weighted string in it, and tack it onto the top of the door, so that when anybody opened the door, that tipped over and the water come down on them. That's the same sort of trick as Tubby played, you see.
Yeah.
With the old pole. Like,
so you get all the information.
Do you live in the village?
No, Homer Green.
Oh, Homer Green.
You may know my father, Ted King.
Yeah.
King.
Oh,
yeah.
King.
Do you know
yeah.
the King?
Well, he's the man who does the little chairs, is he?
I do the little chairs.
Oh, you do the little chairs.
My father does the large ones.
Didn't you come to our chapel?
Well, that's your father. Is that your father that made the pulpit down at the chapel?
Yeah.
And the
yeah.
cross?
Yeah.
Well,
no, I
didn't
you
think
are.
So. Then.
And
that's
the
your father.
And the pulpit and the...
Well, I should know him, shouldn't I? Of course I do.
Communion rail he made, didn't
yeah,
he?
Yeah, that's right, the communion rail.
And the pulpit?
Yeah, that's right.
And, because the cross was made out of Archer's old bed, wasn't it?
Yes.
That was a Danette super, you know, family thing. But
yeah.
So you have been to our church with the little chairs then, at
yeah.
fellowship?
Yeah.
That's some time ago.
That's right, about 3 years ago.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Small world.
Yes, it is, isn't it?
I don't know what he's going to do with this tape.
Well, just take what information is useful to you.